Hello friends, welcome to our channel Right Click Education. In today's video we will learn how we can implement Angular material pagination. So in the last video we learned about how we can implement Angular material table. So today we will implement the pagination on the table. Okay, so let's get started. Open your Chrome, type Angular material. Open this material.angular.io, the official website of Angular Material. Click on component, scroll down, click on paginator. So if you see here, right, this is the pagination. So whenever we have data in one page and we have suppose 100 rows of data that can't be adjusted in single page frame, so we use pagination there in order to navigate to different pages. Okay, so let's see how we can implement it, then you will have the better idea. So let me open my localhost. So if you can see, I have already in the last video shown you how we can implement this table. Now today we will add pagination to this table only. Okay, so let's do that. Click on the API. First we will copy this import mat paginator module. Okay, so copy this module, go to your app.module.ts, scroll up, paste it here, copy this mat paginator module. Under the ng module import section, paste it. Okay, so we are done with the import part. Now let's go to our app.component.html. okay, and we will add tag for pagination. Okay, so let's add that. We will use mat paginator, mat paginator. Okay, now we will add some of the properties to this mat paginator. Okay, first we will add the template reference variable with which we will link this mat paginator further. For now I am adding this template reference variable, that is paginator. Okay, now also add length okay, put it, give it as 100, sorry. Okay, another property is page size options. So on how many number of rows you want to show, okay, that you can bind with this property, that is page size options. Okay, and we will give three value. We will give, like by default it will be 3, then 5, then 10. So we can select between all these three value whatever we want on the screen. Okay, and also we will add one level. Add level, name it as select page. Okay, so we are done with HTML part. Now let's go to our app.component.ts. Here, first we will import some of the modules that we need. So first, import ViewChild, because we have created a, you know, template reference variable. We will link with this ViewChild. So we have imported this one. Now let's import MatPaginator also. Import MatPaginator. Fine. Then also import table data source. Okay. MatTable data source. Okay. Now we had created this view child. Now if you see, if you go to the HTML, you can see we have created this template reference variable. Now we need to link it. So go to your app.component.ts, type @ view child, okay, as paginator. Okay, we create one instance of it, name it as paginator, and this will be of type MatPaginator. Okay, so this is one thing. Now this data source, we need to change it to Mat table data source of periodic element. Okay, so if you remember, right, this periodic element is the interface that we had created, and also we need to invoke the method ng after view init, which is a angular lifecycle hook method that we need to invoke. Okay, so here we will create one instance of data source. This dot data source equals to new Mat table data source. Of element data. Okay, and this dot data source dot paginator equals to this dot paginator. Okay, and so we have implemented this TS also. Okay, now you can get one error if you see this red thing, right? But I'm not getting any compilation error. Why? Because I have added, go to this tsconfig.json. I have added a strict property initialization equals to false. Okay. So if you haven't added this, please add this to your tsconfig.json file. Okay, then you won't get any compilation error, because I am using the latest TypeScript version, that's why I'm getting this error. Okay, so let's go to our UI and see how it looks like. So open localhost. So if you see here, right, the pagination you can see in the right. So we have this page where we have by default three rows you can see, right? But if you click on it, if you click on five, you can see we can now see the five rows, right? And if you select the 10, then you can get the all 10 rows. Again, if you select three, you will get three rows. Okay, so this is how we can implement pagination with our Angular Material table. And also I would like to mention one more properties to this mat paginator. So you can add one property, that is show first last button. Okay, so add this show first last buttons. Okay, so this will be of camel case. Now let's go to our UI and see. So now you can see, right, we have this button also, so you can navigate from here also if you see, right? So in this way you can implement Angular Material table with pagination. Okay, in the next video we will learn how we can implement Angular Material sorting on this table only. Okay, so if you have any doubt regarding this video, please comment below. I will try to answer your questions. And if you haven't subscribed our channel, please do subscribe our channel to get more updates and press the bell icon. Thanks and have a nice day.